Welcome to the Health Room, your health and wellness authority. Vitamin C is a very popular supplement. In fact, billions of dollars worth of vitamin C supplements are being purchased each year worldwide. But many, including you, are not aware of its dangers and side effects. So in this video, we are giving you the exact reasons why you should think twice before taking this very popular vitamin supplement. Vitamin C, also called L-ascorbic acid or ascorbate, is a nutrient that humans must get from food or dietary supplements since it cannot be made in the body. Vitamin C is an antioxidant and helps prevent oxidative stress. It also works with enzymes to play a key role in making collagen. When a person takes more than the recommended limit of vitamin C, they may experience mild digestive disturbances. These can occur if the vitamin C that the body does not absorb irritates the gastrointestinal tract. Common mild side effects of too much vitamin C include diarrhea, nausea, stomach cramping, bloating, and general abdominal discomfort. This video reviews the most common dangers of taking vitamin C, so if you are planning to take it regularly, make sure to watch this video until the end. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to keep you notified and updated with our latest videos. We are trying our best to give you the most informative health-related videos regularly. Having said that, here are the top 10 vitamin C adverse effects you should not ignore. 1. Kidney stones. Kidney stones are a possible consequence of too much vitamin C supplementation. Doctors believe that too much vitamin C supplementation could result in a person excreting the compounds oxalate and uric acid in their urine. These compounds could lead to kidney stone formation. The authors of a case study in the journal Kidney International reported that a woman developed kidney stones after taking 4 grams or more of vitamin C each day for 4 months. However, researchers have not conducted any larger-scale studies on vitamin C intake and kidney stone formation. They do know that people who have a history of kidney stones are more likely to form them if they take large amounts of vitamin C. 2. Nutrient imbalances. Another concern regarding excessive vitamin C intake is that it can impair the body's ability to process other nutrients. For example, vitamin C may reduce the levels of vitamin B12 and copper in the body. The presence of vitamin C can also enhance iron absorption in the body, which could lead to excessively high levels of iron. 3. It can cause bone spurs. According to the Arthritis Foundation, one study found that the presence of very high vitamin C levels in the body increased the likelihood of a person developing painful bone spurs. However, the foundation also cited a research study that found that people with low levels of vitamin C had a higher risk of developing rheumatoid arthritis, a painful inflammatory joint condition. These findings emphasize the need for appropriate vitamin C supplementation that provides neither too much nor too little. 4. Impair the effectiveness of niacin simvastatin. Evidence suggests that taking vitamin C supplements may impair the body's ability to increase high-density lipoprotein (HDL) cholesterol in people taking the combination drug niacin simvastatin. This drug combines the vitamin niacin with the statin simvastatin (Zocor), and people take it to treat high cholesterol. Doctors consider HDL cholesterol the good cholesterol because it reduces the amount of harmful cholesterol in the blood. If a person takes vitamin C supplements and niacin simvastatin, they should talk to their doctor about ways to make each more effective. Doctors do not know whether vitamin C also affects the ability of other medicines similar to Zocor. 5. It can worsen Alzheimer's disease. Taking vitamin C along with vitamin E and alpha-lipoic acid might worsen mental function in people with Alzheimer's disease. 6. Vitamin C may cause miscarriage. Various anecdotal reports have linked vitamin C use with miscarriage as well as self-induced abortion, termination of pregnancy. These reports, however, have not been substantiated by medical research, and attempts to use vitamin C to intentionally terminate a pregnancy may be dangerous. 7. It makes hemochromatosis worse. Hemochromatosis is a condition caused by excess iron buildup in the body. This condition is commonly inherited, and most often affects the liver, heart, and pancreas. Vitamin C helps the body absorb iron. Although vitamin C overdose does not cause hemochromatosis, it can worsen the condition. 8. May cause iron overload. Vitamin C is known to enhance iron absorption. It can bind with non-heme iron, which is found in plant foods. Non-heme iron is not absorbed by your body as efficiently as heme iron, the type of iron found in animal products. Vitamin C binds with non-heme iron, making it much easier for your body to absorb. This is an important function, especially for individuals who get most of their iron from plant-based foods. One study in adults found that iron absorption increased by 67% when they took 100 mg of vitamin C with a meal. However, individuals with conditions that increase the risk of iron accumulation in the body, such as hemochromatosis, should be cautious with vitamin C supplements. Under these circumstances, taking vitamin C in excess may lead to iron overload, which can cause serious damage to your heart, liver, pancreas, thyroid, and central nervous system. 9. It can cause acne and healthy skin. Antioxidants in skincare are bad when they are in concentrated form and disrupt the body's natural ability to fight off bacteria. When are antioxidants in concentrated form? In vitamin C serums. So now it seems, from an oxidation standpoint, vitamin C serums damage the skin in two ways. Their oxygenating effect creates ROS in the skin, which breaks the skin down, creating inflammation, and leading increased susceptibility to pathogenic infection. Their antioxidant effect destroys the healthy ROS created by the body to prevent bacterial infection. The two together create a storm that disrupts the body's ability to maintain a healthy balance, which is why vitamin C serums have destroyed so many people's skin. So if you used a vitamin C serum and it gave you acne, redness, or any other skin issue, it is because the serum took away your body's ability to fight off bacteria and weakened it, inviting pathogens to infect your skin. 10. May cause digestive symptoms. The most common side effect of high vitamin C intake is digestive distress. In general, these side effects do not occur from eating foods that contain vitamin C, but rather from taking the vitamin in supplement form. You're most likely to experience digestive symptoms if you consume more than 2,000 mg at once. Thus, a tolerable upper limit (TUL) of 2,000 mg per day has been established. The most common digestive symptoms of excessive vitamin C intake are diarrhea and nausea. Excessive intake has also been reported to lead to acid reflux, although this is not supported by evidence. If you're experiencing digestive problems as a result of taking too much vitamin C, simply cut back your supplement dose or avoid vitamin C supplements altogether. Ingesting more than 2,000 mg of vitamin C per day may lead to gastrointestinal upset, including symptoms like diarrhea and nausea. People should get most of their nutrients, including vitamin C, from food, advises the federal government's Dietary Guidelines for Americans. Foods contain vitamins, minerals, dietary fiber, and other substances that benefit health. In some cases, fortified foods and dietary supplements may provide nutrients that otherwise may be consumed in less than recommended amounts. Tell your doctor, pharmacist, and other healthcare providers about any dietary supplements and medicines you take before taking vitamin C. They can tell you if vitamin C might interact or interfere with your prescription. Do you know any other vitamin C adverse effects? If you do, please share it in the comments section down below. This way, you are able to help others who are also looking for more information on this subject. Make sure to like or share this video with your friends to inform them as well. Please watch our other health videos to help this channel grow and reach a wider audience. Thanks for watching, The Health Room.